Welcome to our first tutorial on immerGallery. Today, we'll show you all about the menu options and the cool features of immerGallery. We start off with the local gallery. This is where your content from your pictures or your download folder is shown. Let's open one of the pictures. This is now a VR180 3D picture, so we can nicely look around. When we look at our controller, we notice that there are labels attached to it. That makes it easy to remember what button does what. Also, we notice there's a map attached to it. By using the grip button, together with the thumbstick up and down, we can actually change the zoom level on it. By pressing A again, we can open the menu. Up in the top bar, we can, for example, delete the image, mark it as favorite, stop the playback, or start the playback with an automatic image switching time. Over here with the three dots, we have a few special options, for example, sorting by date and so on. Let's stop the playback now and jump over to the sample gallery. Here we have a lot of cool pictures, 180 3D, for example, like this very nice night shot. And we actually can also see the description on top of the controller where it tells us more information about this picture. Back in the menu, down here we have the image information box. It actually shows you the file name and camera data, for example, with which camera it was taken, how long the exposure time was, what ISO setting, and so on. Other pictures in the sample gallery include cylindrical panoramas. We have drone 360 pictures. We actually have 360 3D photos here as well. And we also have, as examples, 2D pictures, which are shown on a cinematic screen. And the same for 3D, comparable to a 3D cinema. For multiplayer, we will do a separate tutorial. But just to quickly tell you, here you can put in a room name, you have to set your region, and you just join in. Your friends do the same. After that, under users, they will be available to be shown to you. Under galleries, you will see which galleries do you have in common, and these ones you can watch together. And of course you can voice chat directly, but you can also type into the chat, for example, sending download links there. Speaking of download, under download we have various tabs. Premium, these are our in-app purchases with very high quality polished content, which has lots of explanations as voiceovers with historical data. For example, we recently released our Egypt DLC, and to get more information, we can press here on the I, and it will show us a bit more detail what we can see, how many images there are. We see a few thumbnails here, and here specifically, actually we have 75 old stereo cards from the beginning of the last century, which are really historical, nice images to watch, and almost like a time travel to go back in Egypt. So yeah, please check that out as well. Under included, there are many galleries that you can download. Some are videos, some are pictures, some are mixed. Here, for example, we have VR180 heavy metal videos in very high quality. We have various photo collections. And as always with the eye, you can just click on it. You get more information what's containing in these galleries. You get thumbnail previews. You get information on what kind of images, like 360, these are. We'll talk later about rewards. The tutorials is what you're watching right now. Paste bin support is something a separate tutorial needs to handle, but let's look at custom URL a little bit. If you do know an internet location where a zip file is located with gallery in it, with pictures and audio, you can actually just type it in here and go to download here. You can also use short URL AT, for example. On that website, you can put in a long URL, which is difficult to type in VR, and it will just give you a 5 to 6 digit afterwards. You can use that digit in here, download it, it will be extracted automatically, and you can view it in immerGallery. So favorites are meant to mark your most favorite pictures. There's different ways how to do it. One is, if you have a picture open in full screen mode, you can press the B button or Y button on the left controller, or in the overview with the thumbnails, you can actually mark them directly if you point at the heart location up here. A third option is also in the top bar menu, there's also this heart icon. Let me show you how to do that. So we open up again picture 4 again. And now we press the B button. And yeah, variety of heights comes up here and flies all up into the sky. When we open the menu again with A, we see, okay, now this picture is marked. If you want to do it faster, you can just click in the top right corner and it will mark Caesar's favorites as well, or unmark them. Now going back to favorites, you will now see these are the two marked favorites you had. Up here with the three dots, you can actually change between different favorite lists. For example, if you want one favorite list to show it to your friends, one to your parents, you can switch back and forth. The next menu point is under Modify Image. You need to have an image open for that to work, and you can now set various special effects here. For example, you can enable birds, and you have interactive birds flying around in your scene. If you want these in all of your images in that folder, you can press here Apply to Folder. If you want to change, save the change in just this image, you can press Save Changes. If you change multiple images in the folder, like with Apply to Folder, you can do Save Changes in Folder here. Here in Expert, if for some reasons the image format detection does not give you what you want, or you want to experiment with different ones, you can press here the plus, it will show you various different options which also can be saved. The rewards are weekly rewards, and we have four of these every month. And if you open the app at the right time where this week is present, you can claim these rewards for free, and they will show you very interesting things every month. And if you collected all these weekly rewards, all four of them, then you also get the free monthly reward, which is usually a little bit larger. Of course, it can happen you will miss some reward at some time. In that case, you can go to Missed Rewards, and here we actually have an overview of currently all rewards. For example, here 2023 in September to December, we have collected all 20 rewards, great. However, in January to April 2024, we are missing 11 rewards. And if you like, you can do an in-app purchase. Just click here and you can complete your selection. The price you currently see is in the developer option. It will be different depending on how many rewards you are missing. Yeah, we also have a video player here in beta. If you want more information why beta and what we are planning to do, you can press up here for more information. Otherwise, all movies from your movies folder, download pictures and video shots, the Oculus video shots folder are listed here. And you can just click on them to start the playback. When you open the menu again, it looks now a bit different. You have various options to stop, to pause, to move forward and so on. You can also enable an artificial 3D cinema. You can disable the top part of the menu in case while you modify something here, you want to have a better overview. If you want to change image formats, there's currently these three sections where flat 180 or 360 content can be changed. Right now, the content is shown as on a cylindrical cinema screen. And for these, we can actually enable an ambient cylindrical cinema screen as well. And this will now extend the colors towards your regular cinema screen. We also have an MP3 player, which basically is the same concept. It scans for your music in music. Under settings, we have a lot of options. Under audio, you can configure all the volumes. You can enable voice control, which I'll tell more about later. Under customize, you can change all the start image setup and various things to your liking. Under offsets, you can, for example, change the menu distance depending on how far you want it to have. You can change the cinema screens, move them up, down, left, right, and so on. Cleanup basically can clean the cache. It mostly resets that immerGallery doesn't know anything about your images anymore. You can clean all downloads as well with a quick press. Advanced, many options here which we need to cover in a separate tutorial, but camera pass-through mode might be something you want to experiment with. We also have a section on phobias. If you have a fear of heights, please make sure to check this out. It will create an artificial floor under all your images if you set it too high. There's also various other fear triggers. If images are marked correctly and you tell us that you have a fear about it, we will skip these images. SMB is basically for networked file access. You can there let it scan for IPs in your local network and it will find where SMB servers are located and you can remotely access these. Under experimental, we also have UPnP, the other way of network access for these data. It's still in beta right now. If you can, I would actually recommend to use SMB instead, but if you only have UPnP available, you can use that here. We also have options for pitch rotation, so if you want to lay down and watch content, you can actually change the rotations of the menu and images right up here. Then under help, if you enter your email address here and you describe us your issue that you're having, we are very happy to help. And after you've typed in a little bit, this button becomes blue and you can send us a log file. For that, please make sure that under settings advanced, you have the verbose logging on, so we really know what's happening. Here are direct links to our social media channels. You can click them, a 2D browser will open, so you can watch it right in VR. Up here, the image generator, that's a very interesting tool that helps you to create your own immersive galleries. So everything you see here, all downloads, all galleries, everything included, you can do yourself. All the features are open to everyone. And Image Generator is a Windows and soon macOS app where you can easily and visually collect your pictures together, add descriptions, link them to audio, and export them as a zip file. And many cool things. You can get it for free at immervr.com. The last feature I mentioned is voice control. And right now, immerGallery, you can of course control with your single controller, but with voice control enabled, you can actually control it with zero controllers, just by voice. For example, if you would be in local gallery and you want the second image to be opened up, you could say select two, you could say open menu, switch to the next image by just saying next. So please give it a try, it's a very interesting input method, and a full list of voice commands is actually available at immervr.com. So this is it, our first tutorial introduction to what things you can do in immerGallery. And we hope you had fun and will have way more fun exploring immerGallery and using it for your own content and downloading lots of rewards and interesting galleries. Thank you very much. Bye bye.